Hi, I'm Dr. Todd Cooperman, president and founder of ConsumerLab.com, which has been testing supplements for over 20 years. And I'm talking to you today about supplements that are being considered for coronavirus. Some of these may be of some help, some may potentially be of help, some may be of no help. And I want you to kind of understand really the reality of supplements for coronavirus. Most importantly, before we even talk about these, most important things if you want to prevent yourself from getting coronavirus are to follow the recommendations being put forward by health authorities of washing your hands, not touching your face, social distancing, and if you are immunocompromised or elderly or have other conditions that would make you more susceptible to a significant disease from coronavirus or COVID-19. Basically, you know, self-quarantining, really keeping yourself away from people as much as possible until there's a vaccine or there's enough herd immunity out there to keep you safe. But the most important thing you can do other than that really is to make sure that you are as healthy as possible, that your immune system is working as well as possible. Before you even think about supplements, make sure you're getting enough sleep, make sure you're eating well, getting some exercise, treating any conditions that you already have with medication to keep them under control. But there are some vitamins and minerals that are important to your immune functioning, and if you are a little deficient in them or very deficient, it will make you more compromised. And so I'm going to talk about a few of those and then other supplements and approaches that may or may not be helpful. So first, vitamin D is an immunoregulatory hormone. In addition to it helping with bone health, it actually helps with your immune system. People who are deficient in vitamin D are more likely to have problems with asthma. It may actually help you, possibly help prevent you from getting an infection. And certainly if you get an infection, it'll help your immune system work better. It is just the end of winter here in the Northern Hemisphere, and people's vitamin D levels are probably close to their lowest all year round at this point. So some people may be deficient or slightly deficient. You want to have a level of at least 20 nanograms per ml. That's the minimum. Probably a sweet spot is about 25 to 35. But if you don't even know your level, that's fine. You can take some vitamin D. I would take basically the recommended amount of vitamin D just to stay healthy and maintain good levels is about 600 to 800 IU per day, which is about 15 to 20 micrograms per day, as that's the newer way of labeling vitamin D. 1,000 is certainly fine. Up to 2,000 is fine. You don't really want to go much higher than that. Getting too much vitamin D, like getting too much of just about any vitamin or mineral, has its downsides. I happen to like vitamin D as a liquid drop, because then you can take just how much you need each day. You can share it with your family members who also take what they need. Not everyone has to take the same amount that way. It's also very inexpensive. We have tested all of these products at Consumer Lab. We have reviews on all of them, and we have a whole free report that you can see about supplements for coronavirus on our site, where you can get some more details about all of this as well, and other supplements. So that's vitamin D. And you can also get it from dairy foods, and plant-based milks have a lot of vitamin D added. So lots of ways of getting vitamin D, but you want to make sure you have enough. Vitamin C is also important for your immune system functioning. It helps white blood cells. You need about 75 to 120 milligrams of vitamin C per day. You can get that from your diet. Most people are not getting too little vitamin C, but to make sure you're getting enough, especially in times when your body is stressed, you can certainly take some extra vitamin C. I'm sorry if I said D before. This is just one example of the products we've taken. You can take up to about 400 or 500 milligrams per day if you really want to. It's probably not necessary. If you start going above that, there is a downside to vitamin C. Long term, it can actually increase the risk of cataracts. If you take the right amount of vitamin D, it'll probably help you avoid cataracts. Too much can also cause digestive issues. So you want to make sure you're getting enough vitamin C. An orange has about, I think, 80, 90 milligrams, a cup of sliced orange. Other fruits and vegetables have even more, peppers, kiwi. So make sure you're getting enough vitamin C. Zinc is also very important. This is an example of one of the products we've tested. This product actually has 50 milligrams of zinc. That's more than you really need. Most people are not deficient in zinc, and you only need about 11 milligrams per day. Unfortunately, most of the supplements on the market have a lot more. You don't want to take that much zinc, too much zinc for too long. It actually inhibits copper absorption. It can actually decrease your immunity if you're getting too much zinc for too long. But you should be getting, you should consider taking some zinc if you're concerned about it. Multivitamins often have zinc. They almost always have some zinc. Look for about 11 milligrams. There was a study done of older people in nursing homes in France where they gave them 20 milligrams, which is a fine, still safe amount of zinc per day, and it actually decreased their risk of getting upper respiratory infections. These people were deficient, though, slightly in zinc to start with. They were also a little deficient in selenium, which is very uncommon to be deficient in the United States. It does happen in other countries. A lot of people in China are deficient in selenium as well. I wouldn't worry too much about the selenium, but you can take a little bit of zinc. It may be helpful to you. Now, the other side of zinc is zinc lozenges, like this lozenge here. Because zinc, when taken as a lozenge, coats the back of your throat, and that's where it can actually inhibit viruses. And this has been shown in a number of studies, not super large, well-controlled studies, but good enough to suggest that taking zinc and coating your throat with it can be helpful. You don't want to bite these, you don't want to chew these lozenges and just swallow them, because that's just giving you a lot of zinc where you're getting too much per day, because these do have about 13 milligrams. Some have about up to 20 or so milligrams per lozenge. And that's about all you need for a whole day, but you're supposed to be taking these periodically to keep your throat coated throughout the day. I wouldn't take a liquid zinc to do that because it'll just go down too quickly. So zinc lozenges, if you get infected, it may be helpful based on what's been shown with other colds and flus. Again, we don't know with the coronavirus that any of these absolutely will help, but this is just based on other research that out there. Other things that are being proposed are elderberry. You may have heard these have flown off the shelf. The evidence for elderberry is not so strong, and the products that have been used have been all varied tremendously. We have a whole review of elderberry supplements. Here are a couple that are in that review, and we found a huge range in terms of the amount of key compounds in these products on the market. Some have a tremendous amount, some have very, very little. So if you're going to consider elderberry, again, probably isn't going to help you. Again, it's one of those that you take around the time when you start getting sick, not constantly. But look at our report on elderberry if you're going to take elderberry. Again, no reason to believe that it's going to help you, though. If you are at home and quarantined, or self-isolating, there are foods that are being recommended. We've tested some of them. For example, canned fish is excellent, great source of proteins, a great source of omega-3 fatty acids, which also have anti-inflammatory properties. So you might want to look at our report on canned tuna and canned salmon, because you don't want to be holed up at home for 2 weeks eating albacore tuna and taking in a lot of mercury. There are better options out there. So you can read about our tests of those products. Some people now are very excited about coconut water. There's really no benefit to coconut water with coronavirus. There's a possible benefit from coconut oil. This is being explored now. It has not been proven. We have a whole review on coconut oils as well, as there's a certain compound within coconut oil that may be helpful. Again, it's just being explored now, but coconut water is really basically very expensive water. It does have a lot of potassium, some sugar, it tastes good. You know, if you enjoy it, that's fine, but there's really no need to stock up on it. And the water supplies, you know, drinking water that's been well cleaned is not gonna give you coronavirus. So you can certainly, you don't have to stock up on even bottled water. unless you're afraid your whole system's going to go down. Other supplements that people are talking about and we've written about, and again is in our free article about supplements for coronavirus on Consumer Lab, are things like ginger, garlic, echinacea, NAC, quercetin. And so we've written about all of those as well. We are constantly adding more information about other products that people are considering or testing. So please check that out. It's free. It's on ConsumerLab.com. If you like these videos, we have videos on many different topics, and they all relate back to big reports on our site. You know, you can subscribe to these videos. Certainly, you can become a member of Consumer Lab as well, so you can get all of our information. Couple of supplements I would stay away from are colloidal silver, which is really more of a disinfectant. It will kill things, viruses, bacteria, kind of on their surface. Some people use it to disinfect water, but you shouldn't be taking colloidal silver directly. Also, there are products, kits that make kind of a bleach. You don't want to be ingesting those either. They will kill things on surfaces, but you don't want to be ingesting those, so stay away from those. So I hope that you stay healthy, keep yourself in as good shape as possible. If you think you're deficient in some things, it's perfectly fine to supplement the way that I've described. I hope you stay well. Thank you.